ongoing.
All right, let's listen into the fire chief now.
Not too long ago by the police, we had been pulled back and actually had police using their shields to protect our personnel anytime they were in line of sight. We did get some streams into play as soon as we could to creatively get some water on the fire over roofs from an aerial master stream. But the problem we had is the potential was there for there to be a shooter still inside the building. At this point, that hasn't been ruled out, nor can we confirm that there's anyone in the building. A family member did escape. I have not spoken to the individual, but the report was that there was still someone on the second floor. The initial arriving crew found fire, a significant amount of fire on the backside of the building. They made an aggressive attack and were prepared to do a search to do the rescue when the shot was heard. We're used to hearing noises at fires. It's not unusual to hear pops and cracks and noises you're not expecting to hear, but this struck them as a shot. That was confirmed by police on the scene, who reacted and ordered everybody away from the building. So at this point, we're transitioning. We would like to go up and finish putting the fire out, but until we have confirmation from the police that it's safe to, what we've done is we've moved into positions where we can get water more directly on the fire. The police are still working with us to safeguard the firefighters. And as soon as it's determined that it's safe and it's reasonable, we're going to go in and put the fire out. But at this point, we have to wait until that time is announced.
What information did that person who self-evacuated provide? Did they say that their family member had ammunition, had guns, had firecrackers, anything?
At this point, I only have minimal information. I heard a report secondhand that there was a firearm, if not more, in the house, and that there were fireworks. We have no indication that someone was intending to shoot at anyone. We were just told that this was possible and that there was somebody believed to be on the second floor where the believed shot was heard.
Chief?
Yes.
Earlier, you said that there were two people known to be the one who got out. I'm concerned that there might be a third person. Now you're saying that one person got out and that person...
I don't believe I said that, Jim, but since that interview, if that was said, it was a misunderstanding. Our report at this time from a detective on the police department is that it's believed there were only two people in the building. One did get out. The other one, they're unsure what happened to that person.
There was another person.
At some point, there was a second person in the building.
Do you believe or is it possible that that second person may have escaped this house and maybe ignited it and ran off? I mean, is that something that you're considering?
Anything is possible, and that's why the police set up a perimeter, not only around the house, but in the neighborhood, to protect the citizens as well as the firefighters. And that's why they pulled us out of line of sight, because if we're in line of sight and someone has a long gun, a rifle, then we're...